हेलो एवरीवन, नमस्ते. आई एम स्वप्ना पेडनेकर फ्रॉम इंडिया. ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ होमोकोन पब्लिक लाइब्रेरी, आई एम वेलकमिंग यू ऑल हियर फॉर दिस वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग सेशन ऑफ ब्रीदिंग एक्सरसाइज. वी कॉल इट प्राणायाम. विल बी लर्निंग इट टुडे. Since all of us are in the all our respective houses locked up, we are not allowed to go out. Same the library, Hoboken library is also closed, but it is working from inside and it's working for you. So on their behalf, I'm in front of you on their Facebook page. So let us start our session. This pranayama is a part of yoga.
You want to say something about yourself? Want to say something about yourself? Okay.
Pranayama is a part of yoga. Yoga is a science. It's an ancient science with Indian origin. It is universal and eternal. Our great Indian saint, Maharishi Patanjali, he invented and formulated Ashtanga Yoga. Ashtanga Yoga has 8 parts: Yama, Niyama, Asana, Pranayam, Pratyahar, Dharana, Dhyana, Samadhi. Learning all these is a very big subject, very vast. It takes lot of time. We are not going so deep into it. So we have now today gathered and arranged this lecture about the pranayama, as one part of yoga, which is a breathing exercise. So we'll go deeper into it, we'll practice it, we'll see what are the different pranayama and how it will help us. So now, why we need it urgently, this pranayama, that is breathing exercise? Because of the situation around, all of you know that this COVID-19 pandemic has put us all into trouble. We are locked in our houses, have a lot of tensions. So many things are going around and creating more and more tensions within us, tensions within the family and the friends. So to reduce that tensions, make us healthy physically, mentally, emotionally, we will be learning first and then practicing every day, because every day practice is very important and we are going to do it, isn't it? So what is pranayama? As I told you, it is a breathing exercise. It is cautiously organizing, directing and controlling the process of inhaling and exhaling oxygen into our body. So with this process, a magical change happens in our body. The oxygen reaches to every tissue, every cell of the body, and it energizes us. The entire body gets oxygenated blood supply and we feel very energetic, stressless. Because of the stress, lot of negative thoughts come in our mind, so we have to get rid of them. We have to be very positive, very strong. So this pranayama is going to make us strong to fight against all the odds. Namely, now this corona, COVID-19 pandemic. So let us do it. Let us learn it, and we will be practicing it every day. Okay. So this pranayama, when we will be learning, we have to know first. Now we have seen the definition. What is pranayama? It is a breathing exercise, and how it helps, because it is controlling, generating, and processing of this, our inhaling and exhaling of oxygen. So this, up to this we have come. Now we have to see how we will be doing. There are certain conditions. Doing pranayama early in the morning is the best. But suppose if you are not able to get up early, then you can do in the evening also. Early morning, we have to do it empty stomach. Evening, if we are doing, we'll have to do it 3 hours after food. Minimum 3 hours. If it is 4 or 5 hours, it is the best. But minimum 3 hours after food is the requirement. So this is the basic, the time. Then the place where we'll be sitting for pranayama. Pranayama, we need quiet place, clean place, and surrounded by the greenery. If there is a water pond around, that will be still better. All the positive vibes should come in with us with the oxygen. That is what is required. So the place will be very pleasant, airy, and clean and nice. Now, since everybody is in the house, everybody is working from home, children are at school, because everything is closed. Schools, colleges, offices, everything is closed. So everybody is working from home. So all the family members can sit together. Children, parents, grandparents, they can sit together and do the pranayama. So the sitting arrangement will come. Next point, the sitting arrangement. Sitting arrangement, we have to sit on the hard surface. With a floor, if we are sitting, there should be carpet or mat. Only floor bare without a carpet or mat is not allowed, because not allowed means it's not good. Pranayama will be of no use. If you sit only on floor without any cover on it, then the energy we have generated through pranayama will get grounded. So, and our efforts will go waste. That's why we have to take either mat or a carpet on the floor, and we will be sitting there. Elders who are not able to sit on the ground can sit in the chair. If somebody is sick, not well, and can't sit also on the chair, they can lie down and do pranayama. They will get the results. That much useful this pranayama is. So this is for everybody, right? A child from 3 years onwards to any age. Upper age is no limit. And at any stage of illness also, you can do the pranayama and achieve the desired results. But it takes little time for it. Everything is possible if we do it with lot of determination and sincerity and devotion. Of course, for every work we need this, isn't it? And now it is a very important work, very difficult situation we are handling, and we are going through a very difficult stage of our life, and we have to get through it. Okay, so we'll be doing it. This place is now decided. The posture, what you have to do is, when you are, if you are sitting on the floor, you have to keep your legs folded one upon another, called in Sukhasana. Sukha is comfort. So in a comfortable asana, means posture, you will be sitting. There are so many asanas, but we have no time to look into that. So now we will decide upon Sukhasana. And in the chair, if you are sitting, then keep your legs folded on each other and your feet on the floor, folded, of course. those who are lying down on the bed can't get up, they can lie down straight on their back. Then your spine should be straight, erect. The neck and the spine in one line. That is always required. Then one more thing is, when you are doing pranayama, your eyes should always be closed. You can't do pranayama with open eyes. You have to keep your eyes closed to see within, because pranayama is for the internal body. This is internal body exercise. In gym we go, there we do external body exercise, isn't it? The results we get internally also. But this is necessarily internal. So we have to keep our eyes closed and be within ourselves fully. No attention here and there. And then our hands in Dhyana Mudra. On the tips of our fingers, two fingers, thumb and the index finger, will be getting them together, and these three other fingers will keep straight, and like this the Dhyana Mudra will keep it on our laps, both the hands on our lap. Now we'll be starting Bhastrika Pranayama. There are actually 8 pranayams, but for the convenience and most important for the present situation, we'll be learning 6 pranayams here. So all together I will not go into the name. I will tell you one by one, easy for you to remember. Okay. So Bhastrika Pranayama. If you, it is difficult for you to pronounce or remember this name Bhastrika, you can only remember inhale and exhale. So we have to inhale, long breathe like this, and exhale long. Long means as per individual's capacity, 3 to 5 seconds long. So some can take long breathe up to 3 seconds, some can 5, but the long breathe will reach up to the diaphragm. Diaphragm is the organ connecting our chest and stomach, that is diaphragm. And when the breath goes in, the diaphragm is to be expanded 100%. Understood? Yes. And our lungs get full with air. These two things we have to remember, and we have to breathe in from both the nostrils. I will show you. Just watch it and then you do it. Okay. So I will close. I'm closing my eyes and I have kept my hands in Dhyana Mudra on my lap, and I'm starting it. Inhale, exhale, pranayama. Got it? You start doing it and listen again what I am telling you. With this pranayama, all our respiratory system gets cleared. It is very essential in present days. Our respiratory system is to be kept clean and healthy all the time during this difficult time of coronavirus. So this pranayama gives you the best use of your respiratory system by cleansing them. Keep doing it. You have to do it for 3 minutes. If you do it 5 minutes, can do it 5 minutes, it's very good. But because of the time constraints, we have made it up to 3 minutes. Okay. So breathe in, breathe out, long breathe up to 3 to 5 seconds, I can say, and till your diaphragm gets expanded up to 100% and your lungs get full of air. So the air, oxygen, goes into the smallest tissues, cells of the lungs. Each part of the lung is having about 7 lakh cells, and all these cells get alive, regenerated, energized with this pranayama. We feel very fresh and very energetic. Obviously, because the entire body is getting the blood oxygenated blood supply. Okay. So I'm sure all of you have finished your first pranayam, that is Bhastrika pranayam, inhale and exhale. Now the second pranayam is Kapalabhati. Kapalabhati, we have to keep exhaling. Inhaling happens automatically. So once at a second, we have to exhale. You can remember, if you don't remember the name Kapalabhati, you remember only exhale and keep exhaling once at a second. Again, in our Dhyana Mudra, eyes closed, spine erect, just observe first and then start. Very good. Now you started. Some must have already started. Some must be already doing pranayam. They will get some more tips and follow it meticulously. When we are exhaling, this inhaling happens automatically. You need not have to pay any attention to it. It happens automatically. And when you exhale, your stomach goes little inside. So inhale, exhale, with the inhale, exhale, the stomach keeps inhaling and exhaling in and out, it goes in and out, and you keep inhaling and exhaling. So that's with that, what happens, all the toxins in our body, they get thrown away. They are thrown away with the force, because we are exhaling with little force. So these toxins get away. And how many times we will be exhaling? If you will count, for a second, once, means for a minute, 60 times. And for 10 minutes, we will be doing this pranayam for 10 minutes minimum time. So within 10 minutes, 600 times we'll throw the air out. So all the toxins saturated in our body are thrown away. You are experiencing it. Just keep imagining it is happening. It is happening. The toxins, the tensions on your body, on your mind are getting out of your body, and they are making you relax in bliss. If it is possible, with every exhaling, meditate with Om in your mind. It will really lead you to the bliss, eternal bliss. So, 10 minutes, this exercise, Kapalabhati. If after 5 minutes you get tired, you can wait for a while and then again start it. but you have to complete minimum 10 minutes. Okay, then we will be doing Ujjayi Pranayam. Ujjayi Pranayam we have to do with throat only. Little difficult to do, but once you understand, you will do it easily. So what we have to do, we have to contract inside our throat. From inside we have to contract and breathe in, keeping our mouth closed. Breathe in, long breathe whatever possible, then hold it. Keep the chin near to our chest till you can hold. Thereafter, lift the chin up and leave the air from left, closing your right nostril with your right thumb. I'll show you. Got it? Those who have not understood, I'll show again. You can start. 5 times we have to do this. Listen to me what I'm telling you. With this pranayama, any conjunction in our throat gets cleared. Any problem in the throat. It's very important, especially in the present days. So you are doing this pranayama for 5 times. Ujjayi Pranayama, or just remember cleansing of your throat. If you find it difficult to remember the name Ujjayi, then you remember only cleansing the throat. So first pranayama we learned is inhale exhale, the second is exhale only, third is cleansing the throat 5 times. First pranayama 3 minutes, second pranayama 10 minutes, third pranayama 5 times. Okay, so we'll now go further to anulom pranayama. Anulom vilom pranayama is inhaling and exhaling alternatively with our right and left nostril. So we have to use both the nostrils alternatively, and this right hand fingers, thumb and the 2 fingers, middle and the ring finger, for closing our left nostril, and thumb for the right nostril. Start from left. First inhale, then exhale from right. Again inhale from left. Sorry, inhale from right. And leave to left. Inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale. We have to start from left, and while stopping, just close at left only. So I'm showing you. With the thumb, I have closed my right nostril. From left, I will inhale. With the two fingers, I have closed my left nostril. I'm exhaling with the right. Again, I'm inhaling from right. Exhaling to the left. So this process will have to continue for 10 minutes. I think everybody got the procedure. I'll show you again. Okay. The entire process together takes about 12 seconds. Long inhale, long exhale. You know, we have in our body 72,72,210 veins, blood veins. And all these blood veins gets oxygenated blood supply if we do this pranayama regularly for minimum 10 minutes. It helps for our concentration, for balancing our personality, balancing our anger, balancing our temperament. Because the left nostril, it implies the vibrations from the moon. That is cool, silent vibrations. And the right nostrils, breathing, it implies the vibrations from the sun, the solar vibrations, always energetic. So that energy and coolness makes us balanced. That is, now this Anulom Vilom Pranayam is 10 minutes is over. We will now shift to Bhramari Pranayam. Bhramari Pranayam we have to do five times. So in that pranayam, what we have to do, keep our index finger here, our three fingers on index finger little above our eyebrow, three fingers on our eye and the thumb on our ears, and keep our mouth closed and chant Om from the nostril. I'll show you. That's all. You have understood and you are doing it. Five times we are doing. Okay. Now Omkar, the Git Pranayam, five times. Close your eyes, sit straight. Like this, five times chanting. Bhramari Pranayam, one thing I forgotten to tell you, it's the sound like bee. Bee humming. Just remember that bee humming pranayama, and this is Omkar. That's all. Friends, I hope you have liked it, understood it, liked it, and you will follow it. I thank you all on behalf of Hoboken Public Library. Though they are closed, their doors are closed, they are working online, and they are always available for you for all your requirements, for all the services on their website, hobokenlibrary.org. Thank you. See you again next week. Bye.